Hello everyone, Randy O'Neill here, and we are going to start the very first video in a series of videos to come on how to use Microsoft OneNote, creating notebooks. I'm going to be working on the 2013 platform. I will do a little bit of bouncing back to cover what the differences may be if you're on 2010. In addition to that, I'm working in Windows 8. You may be working in Windows 7 or possibly XP. If you're working in XP, today's March the 11th. You have approximately 1 month to upgrade from XP before Microsoft quits offering support. So I'm not going to cover anything in XP, hoping that everybody's getting current. And there's not going to be a whole lot to cover in the operating system anyway. Once we get OneNote open, the difference between 8 and 7 is really not going to make any difference. So if you're in Windows 8, then what you're going to want to do, if you don't already have OneNote added to your start menu up here, then you're going to come down right here. Let me do that again. This little drop down arrow. This is going to bring up all of your apps, and typically over here to the right a little bit is where you'll see all of your different Microsoft apps, and that's where you'll find OneNote. You can right-click that and choose to send it to your start menu. In my case, I'm not going to do that because I already have it on my start menu, so I'm going to come over here, and I'm going to choose OneNote. If you're in Windows 7, simply start menu, all programs, Microsoft Office, and then OneNote. Another thing that I want to go over real quick, when you first open OneNote on your computer, I have found oftentimes, especially in the classrooms when we do our re-imaging, I have discovered that a lot of times when you open OneNote, the ribbon does not appear. If you are working in the Windows 7 atmosphere, this little arrow in the top right hand corner here, I'm going to click that. If you're in Windows 7, you would have a little arrow pointing down. You would simply click that button and that would bring your ribbon back up. Here in Windows 8, however, in the top right corner, you hover over this little box here, Ribbon Display Options. If you click that and select Show Tabs and Commands, then that will bring your ribbon back. From there, the notebook that opens by default the very first time that you ever open OneNote is a how to use OneNote, some tips and tricks in there that Microsoft offers that would be sitting in the body here. In my case, I've opened a notebook before, so I'm not going to get that window. So from here, what we want to do is go ahead and start learning how to create our own notebook. And the way we're going to do that, we're going to come up here to the File tab. This is also known as the backstage view. If you're not aware of that, you need to go ahead and start pounding that into your brain. Backstage view, because that is what it's referred to across most Microsoft Office platforms now. So the File tab is the backstage view. When you click on the File tab, you will receive a series of options here. We're not going to go through all of these right now. We want to create a new notebook. So I want you to click New. If you happen to be working in a location or connected to a computer that is on a network, you're going to see an extra option in this pane right here. I'm not at work, so I don't have a network to connect to. You're going to have three options. You can create your new notebook in OneDrive. This is also known as SkyDrive. Just a very short time ago, Microsoft changed the name from SkyDrive to OneDrive. Why, I don't know. Maybe there's a reference or a relevance between OneNote and OneDrive. But OneNote is a collaborative program. And as we get deeper into the lessons, you'll learn that you can put your OneNote notebooks in the cloud. You can share them with anybody in the world. Your kids can use these for schoolwork, projects that they're working on with other students. They can do it in the cloud as well. The network, that's going to be the internal network at your place of business, or if you happen to have a network at home, it would be something that anybody within that network could use, but not on the internet. But the option we're going to use today is computer. You can create a OneNote notebook on your computer develop it the way you want it, get all the little bells and whistles working the way you want them, and then once you've got everything tweaked just the way you want it, then you can either add it to the network or you can add it to your Drive account. But for this lesson, we're going to go with computer. And now we need to give this notebook a name. I think the sample that I will use as we go out throughout these lessons, we're going to create a notebook that could be used for home bill management purpose, possibly grocery list included. So anything from your power bill to your mortgage, so on and so forth. We'll have notebooks for that. So let's go ahead and name this notebook Home Bills. Once you've typed the name, you'll click Create Notebook. The folder with this name already exists. Okay. For me, I'm going to do Home Bills 2. If you want to add a 2 to yours so you don't get confused later on, feel free. But Home Bills is going to be the main focus here. So once you've done that, click Create Notebook, and we now have a new notebook. Now, on the 2013 platform, which is the platform that I'm working on here, my notebooks are going to appear right here in the top left bottom of my ribbon. If I click this little down arrow, it's going to show me all of the notebooks that I have. I've got some that are closed to include Home Bills. If you're in Windows 7, you're just going to have a default navigation pane over here on the left-hand side with a little arrow where you can collapse it and make it smaller. But this is your notebook. So if you click this little button right now, you should have one. I believe the default name is Personal. That's the one Microsoft gives you with tips and tricks. And then now you would have one called Home Bills. So that is creating a notebook. Now, once our notebook is created, we will start dressing it up, creating multiple sections, many pages, just to kind of go over the navigation pane a little bit, or the interface. This is your file tabs. When I say file tab, this is what I'm referring to. This is your ribbon up here. It's been across Microsoft Office since 2007. These are your section tabs up here at the top. If I click this, you'll see, and I don't want you to do this. I don't want you to create a bunch of sections that you don't need. But these are your sections. These are your pages. And then within these pages, we'll have subpages. And you'll kind of learn the difference between them. And then here are your notebooks. Okay, so looking at this interface from left to right, this is your notebook. These are the sections. These are your pages. An example that I like to use, this is your file cabinet. These are the green folders within your file cabinet with the little tabs up at the top. And then this is all the stuff that goes inside those green folders that you may place in the little yellow manila folders and stick down inside. So, file cabinet, green dividers, yellow folders, and the stuff that goes in them. All right, so real quick, file, backstage view, new, computer, name your notebook, and then click create. I'm not going to do this. I'm just walking you through the steps again. All right, and that's it for today's lesson. The next video that comes out will be creating sections and pages. I don't know how many videos we'll have in this series. We'll have as many as it takes to cover this entire platform so that you know everything you need to know about OneNote. Thank you again for tuning in. I welcome comments. If you want the rest of the videos, please subscribe below. And please feel free to critique. If there's something that you think I can do different as I move forward with the videos, please tell me that. And I will do anything I can to improve them. Outside of that, remember to subscribe, follow me here, and I'll see you in Lesson 2.